Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.6 and iOS 14.7 Beta 1 have been out for a few days or over a week, depending on which one we're talking about. And I wanted to go over the overall use, what it's like, battery life, performance, bugs, and more, as well as a couple different additional features and when to expect iOS 14.7. But the first thing I want to talk about is iOS 15, since that should be out, as far as beta testing goes, within a week or two at this point. So not too far off should we see the first version and what's in it. And there's been some more leaks about that recently. I covered some of these in the previous news update video, but the first thing has to do with health. So if you use Apple's health app, and maybe you're using health, in health in iOS 15, it's said that there's going to be new food tracking options. So we can track our blood oxygen, depending on the Apple Watch we have, sleep, steps, and more, but we'll also be able to have food tracking options. And this would make a lot of sense. Someone brought this up previously, that if we have an Apple Watch and maybe a Series 7 Apple Watch that maybe is revolutionary, that can track blood glucose levels, it would be amazing to sort of include that along with food tracking in the health app. Now, of course, food tracking is a whole separate thing, but if you could include both, maybe we'll see that in Watch Series 7 or not, but hopefully one day we'll have a breakthrough with that and just be able to track blood glucose levels for those who are diabetic with just an Apple Watch. So it would make sense to start with the health app, adding food and more. So that's the first thing. The next thing is there's supposedly going to be changes to dark mode. So whatever that means specifically, we're not really sure, because that's all that has been said. There will be changes to dark mode. So maybe it will be a little bit darker than it was before in certain menus. Sometimes these are a little bit gray. It could be a pure dark menu in settings, for example. That would be a little bit better. So as far as battery life and more, since it wouldn't have to turn on the Pixel. So that makes a lot of sense that they would make additional changes there. Also, some people have said that there's going to be changes to notifications. So for example, these notifications, some people love them, some people don't, but there should be some updates to make it a little bit better for those that don't really like it. What that means exactly, I'm not sure. I do like how they're spaced out, but I'm not sure if they're going to change the grouping, maybe add customization. I would love to see some more of that in the future updates. Also, with messages, there's said to be some updates as well. So in messages, maybe we'd be able to recall a message. This was rumored for iOS 14 as well. And maybe we'll be able to recall a message within the first minute or something along those lines with iMessage. We don't know for sure, but again, people are just saying to expect some changes with the messaging app. And then I've talked about this before, the lock screen should get a redesign, as well as the control center as well. So we should see all of those changes coming with iOS 15. And that's not too far off. On June 7th, we'll see it at WWDC, and we'll have the beta right after that. So I can't wait to see what they have there. Now with iOS 14.6, there's a couple features I didn't mention in the initial What's New video that were mentioned to me a little bit later on, or that were found later on. And the first one has to do with Apple Watch. Those who have a Series 3 Apple Watch are seeing messages more and more to either delete maybe apps or things like that from their Series 3 Apple Watch to free up storage before installing watchOS 7.5, or if they don't have enough storage overall, it's encouraging them to disconnect your Apple Watch from your iPhone, unpair it, update, and then repair it. So it's kind of a workaround. It seems like Apple wasn't anticipating this, because you're going to have to reset your Apple Watch just to update it. And they still sell the Series 3. So I would expect watchOS 8 to support Series 3 as well, unless they change something there, but they still sell it. So I would expect at least a few more years support with that. So it's kind of an odd workaround. Maybe they'll fix that in the future where it takes up less memory. But normally you'll install an update either on your iPhone or your Apple Watch. It'll install, update everything, and then delete the install file to save space. Generally, that's how it's done, and it just takes a few days for that to happen, or right afterward. It just depends on the device. So that's normally how it works. Unfortunately, seems like it's a bug, though, that they had to do a workaround for. Now, the other thing in iOS 14.6 that's been updated is shortcuts. So if we go into shortcuts, if you use Apple's shortcuts app, it's much, much faster with iOS 14.6, significantly faster. So for example, you'll see I have a flashlight off shortcut. If I turn the flashlight or torch on, depending on where you're from, we'll go back to shortcuts. You can see it's shining below. I'll tap on flashlight off and it turns off immediately. It's almost immediate the second you tap on it. So again, flashlight off and it's off immediately. So it works really well now. I'm glad to see they continue to update this and make it much, much faster. I think we'll see much more customization with that again with iOS 15. Now, as far as the overall experience on iOS 14.6, iOS 14.7, I have iOS 14.6 on my iPhone 11 and iOS 14.7 Beta 1 on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. I actually installed it on the 12 Pro Max a few days after running iOS 14.6 so I could give you an idea overall of what it's like on the same device. And in general, 14.6 is pretty good for most people. My wife, for example, and my daughters that both run that have not had any complaints. However, they're not heavy users and they just haven't said any problems have occurred with it. However, quite a few people are seeing bugs with iOS 14.6 still. For example, quite a few people are seeing issues with Bluetooth still, and the Bluetooth bug seems to be a regular thing that's not only on iOS 14.6, but also 14.7 Beta 1. It seemed to be improved with 14.6 for me connecting to a car with audio, for example, but then with 14.7 Beta 1, it seems sort of slow to connect. And based on some of the modem build numbers, for example, it might be a little bit older than 14.6 in some ways with that Bluetooth connection. So there's something there that still is an issue that hopefully Apple will fix soon, because Bluetooth has been a problem for a while. There's also many who mentioned delays in Bluetooth on both versions. So maybe you connect your AirPods Pro or AirPods Max. Sometimes they're very slow, not only just to connect, but also maybe to play music out of. So you'll see now it finally popped up. It took a while to activate and then pop up, and then actually playing music through those AirPods can have a couple second delay from time to time. So many are saying they're having that experience. So that seems to be an issue on both versions for some reason. Also on 14.6, quite a few people are still having the phone heat up unusually warm. Now, not everyone is. Most people say it's actually doing well, but there are some people who are having the phone get abnormally warm for some reason. So along with that Bluetooth bug and notifications, there's a heating issue there as well. Now on iPadOS 14.6, I'm having a rotation bug on the latest M1 iPad Pro. Now, it's something that I'm not sure if it's specific to the M1, but I am seeing it from time to time. It will be delayed. Sometimes it just won't rotate. Other times it will. I'm not able to reproduce it here, but sometimes that does happen. However, it seems to function fine. Other than that, I've had no issues, no Bluetooth issues, no Wi-Fi issues, but there is a Wi-Fi bug that people are still having. So to go along with the Bluetooth issue, quite a few people on iOS 14.6 still have Wi-Fi issues. Some do on 14.7, but there is a Wi-Fi bug where calls would drop, and a few people mentioned that. So calls could be dropping on iOS 14.6, for example. So that's something that they've updated. Whether or not that has to do with an update to your router or with the iPhone in general, it didn't happen before, so it must be the iPhone. Also, CarPlay used to be a problem. It seems to be resolved for most people with iOS 14.6 and 14.7, where it would drop off. iOS 14.6 RC2 that they released later on, it seems like that's why they released RC2, is some CarPlay issues maybe, where it was dropping off and not working properly. So that makes a lot of sense if that's why they released it. After that update, people were able to use CarPlay, and then Open Music, for example, within CarPlay, it would crash before for a lot of people. So it seems much better. As far as green tint, on both versions on OLED displays, most people say it's resolved. There's occasionally a few people that say it's not, but the majority of people say that they're not seeing a ring around the edge of anything when on a dark page, whether it be settings or in a video. And the HDR video issue people were having doesn't seem to be a problem either. When it's in HDR and there's blacks on the display, they don't seem to be backlit as much. Most people are saying that those issues that were there before are resolved. Now, there is one other issue that I've had with iOS 14.7, and that is it actually occasionally freezing up or locking up. People are seeing this on iOS 14.6 and 14.7, where it will just not respond sometimes, touch is a little slow, and it will lag or freeze. It's pretty hit or miss. It seems to be within specific apps like Instagram, for example, and maybe that has something to do with the app tracking transparency being blocked on that, and it doesn't like it. So it seems to be app specific, but not throughout the OS. So definitely there's something there when it comes to that. However, on iOS 14.7 Beta 1, most people are saying performance is quite good. In fact, most people say it's a very large increase over 14.6 as far as the smoothness, overall performance, and speed in general, which is a good thing because most people say iOS 14.6 was smoother than 14.5 or 14.5.1. So in general, it seems to be a much better update overall. Most people are having a good experience with 14.7, and we should be at this point where it should be refined enough to be a good experience for everyone. So as far as performance, it's doing quite well. Now, as far as battery life, a lot of people with 14.6 mentioned unusual battery drain. Now, quite a few people say that it's better than the previous version, but there are some people that have the heating issue I mentioned before that have unusual battery drain. So there may or may not be an app there that's causing a problem for some people. So what specifically it is, I wish we could pinpoint it down to a specific app that's causing that issue, but it seems to be a few groups of people are saying that they're having significant battery drain with 14.6, but 14.7 resolves that for most people. Now with iOS 14.6 and 14.7 battery life overall, well, I've run both versions on my iPhone 12 Pro Max so I could show you. So if we go to battery, go to battery health, I'm still at 100% on my main device. Again, I've charged this every single night on a fast charger. It's a MagSafe Belkin fast charger. That's the Belkin stand I reviewed. If you haven't seen that, it's in a previous video, but I charge it on that, fast charge it every night, no issues there. And then I put it on a wireless charger in my car. I rarely plug it in and I don't use a case so heat can sort of dissipate off of it. So it seems to help with that. Now over the last 10 days, you can see right here is basically where I installed 14.7 beta 1. So the first four bars or so is iOS 14.6. So with the same apps, I was getting about 2 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time and 3 hours and 39 minutes of screen off time playing music that day. The day before I had 3 hours and 3 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours of screen off time, and used about 50% of my battery or 40 to 50% of my battery. So maybe double this to 6 hours, but that's also 12 hours of playing music in the background while I sleep or something like that. It just depends. So what it's actually doing for background activity. However, background activity is turned off on Twitter, but it keeps showing up. So that's something I keep seeing regularly. However, when we get to iOS 14.7 beta 1, and you'll see that bug, it keeps jumping up. So 14.7 beta 1, here's one of the days I used 1 hour and 40 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 38 minutes of screen off time, and didn't even use a quarter of the battery. So 2 hours, if you times that times four, or times four, we'd get 8 to 10 hours of screen on time. And then the next day, again, we used a lot more and used a lot more battery. So it's, again, hit or miss for me. And you'll see background activity on Telegram, Twitter, Realtor, and other things. So I need to make sure that's turned off as it keeps using a lot of background activity there for some reason. But in general, 8 to 10 hours, I'm getting the same battery life I always did with my iPhone, 50% by the time I go to bed generally is what I'm getting. And I took this off the charger this morning. We're at 70%. And that was 8 hours ago at this point. So it's doing quite well. Now, for those of you wondering about my iPad I've talked about in the past, well, with the M1 iPad Pro, battery life is now 8 to 10 hours of screen on time. However, with the previous one I was having 5 hours of screen on time with, I'm still experiencing that. So there's got to be something bad with the restore that I did on it, even though I wiped the device. So I'll start that one over and it should fix that problem. And this one is doing just fine. So I'm pretty glad to see that this is back to normal. It had to be some apps I had installed. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 14.6 or iOS 14.7 beta 1, well, if you want to stay on public versions, iOS 14.6 is the way to go because of the security updates. There are a huge amount of security updates that are significant. And if I go to Apple's security website, and if we scroll down here, you can see the updates, iOS 14.6 and iPadOS 14.6. And if you just scroll down, there are a ton of security updates here. So everything from WebKit to Model IO to, we'll keep going here, I believe kernel as well, and much, much more. So there are a huge amount of updates in 14.6 as far as security, and I would highly recommend it if you haven't already, just for that alone. However, if you want to try out 14.7, it seems to be more refined and with better performance for most people. So if you're familiar with the beta program, well, then definitely go ahead and try that out. If you're not and you'd like public versions, well, 14.6 seems to be the better way to go for most people. Not everyone, though. Now, as far as iOS 15, like I said, we'll see that in a couple weeks, so I can't wait for that. And also, I want to talk about the YouTube community poll, since all of those things that are still going on with iOS is where you mentioned those. So if we go into YouTube, and as you can see, there's 14,000 votes at the time of this video, which is a huge amount, so I really appreciate that. And you'll see 66% of you say that iOS 14.6 is great, 7% say that it's terrible. 14.7 beta 1, 9% are using it and say that it's great, 2% are saying that it's terrible, and then 15% are on iOS 14.5.1 or older. There's also 274 comments, and again, that's where I get all the information as far as the additional bugs people are having. And so let's sort this so we can take a look at these. I wish we could sort by oldest first, but we'll read about 10 of them or so to see what you had to say. So running iOS 14.7 beta 1 on iPhone 7, 32 GB, no problems here. The battery and performance is good. And that's from Elmo. So I appreciate the comment, and many people are saying that even with older devices, that they're seeing better performance with 14.7 with those betas. So I think it'll increase over time. Abhishek Lamba says, hi Aaron, on iOS 14.6 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, working fine, but sometimes frame rate drop can be seen. Battery life is around 8 to 9 hours max. Love all your videos and thank you. And thanks for commenting. Leeds United History says 14.7 beta 1 on iPhone 11. Can't post videos or photos to Twitter from my photos since I updated. Why? Maybe you have the option turned off that allows you to actually view photos or videos. That could be an issue with that. iOS wouldn't affect whether or not you could post on Twitter, though, so make sure you have that turned on in your privacy settings. Jazjeet Singh says, iOS 14.6 as a whole is smooth, but I've noticed some app bugs, like YouTube becomes unresponsive as content doesn't load up. Sometimes while watching Instagram stories, a black screen pops up. While listening to songs via AirPods Pro and Apple Music, and at the same time using the app switcher, the playing song skips/stops playing for that instant when I swipe up the screen to switch apps. AirPods Pro have some issues. Songs/content on YouTube starts after a few seconds later. The rest, everything is buttery smooth. Alejandra Alvarez says, iOS 14.6 is smooth but terrible on battery. iOS 14.5.1 calibration gave me 100% battery health, and it was really good with battery life. My friend also confirms the same. iPhone 11, 100% battery health, and not happy. Debbie says, iOS 14.7 beta 1 is just okay on my iPhone 11 Pro and iPad Pro, seeing issues with AirPlay connections disappearing. Mail app is being slow, sometimes the keyboard response problems. Or sometimes there's keyboard response problems. Jeremy Smith says, iOS 14.7, iPhone 11, working well and fast. Krunash Yadav says, hopefully I'm saying that properly, hi Aaron, I'm using iOS 14.7 beta 1 on my iPhone 7. No lag so far. It's been great, and battery life is also pretty good. I'm getting around 5 hours of screen on time with 5 to 10% left at night. Rushyanth Reddy says, I'm using an iPhone 10 and running iOS 14.6. Sometimes the apps get crash and battery life is good. The Roblox Dodge HQ says, iPhone 11 on iOS 14.6. It's been great so far. Performance and battery life also seems to be slightly better. Tech1 TV said, I'm using iPhone SE 2 with iOS 14.6 and it's great so far. So that's it for iOS 14.6 and 14.7 beta 1. Now, when it comes to iOS 14.7 beta 2, hopefully we'll see that at the latest by Wednesday. Generally, with the updates, the previous iOS 14.7 update was on a Wednesday, so that would make it almost 2 weeks or 2 weeks at that point until the update. So maybe before then, but hopefully at the latest by then. That seems to make sense, unless Apple has some other plans as well. Hopefully this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments below if these sort of videos are something you find helpful with all this information, or would you like to see less information? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and thanks for watching this far into the video. I really appreciate it. If you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.